perception. When you start to talk to customers, it's a much bigger issue than they might first admit. Nobody wants to kind of promote the fact that they've got lots of damaged legs, but actually once you get them to open up and talk about it a little more, it's a common problem. And when a rack collapse occurs, it's pretty catastrophic, you know. Firstly, somebody could lose their life. Somebody, you know, could have life-changing injuries. That's the worst case scenario. But it can also massive disruption to your business. But that was the primary reason behind it, was we were still seeing a lot of damage, and we thought, well, how can we help prevent this? We've got a barrier and that kind of protection. But what could we do? Where could we use some technology to predict where this is going to be? And that's really what RackEye is about as much as anything. It's about predicting where future issues are likely to occur. So there's nothing out there that does that.
So afternoon, everybody. If Alana didn't mention, obviously my name's Harry and I look after the RackEye system for the UK.
You know what we're like here at SAFE, we try to innovate and think of and predict, you know, try and identify opportunities. We have always had our R&D team. The R&D team said, oh, this could be something we could develop. Let's look at this idea and see if we can build on that.
We built our own team. We brought in specialists in cloud computing and Internet of Things, in embedded software, in electronics. And we really built everything from the ground up so that we could have a solution that was exactly what we wanted to deliver to the customers, and that we knew the customers would get a huge amount of value from. So that was my sort of initial inroads into ASAFE, and sort of building that team from scratch has been, you know, my life's work for the last few years, basically.
And then we presented it at various different forums, just as open days of places, and just gave people a little flavour of what it was going to be. And it really triggered a lot of interest very, very quickly. When they get a really bad hit, so let's say somebody's clipped a leg two or three times over a 6-month period and they've reported it, the next time they hit one, they can completely damage it. I'm in big trouble now. So what tends to happen is the really bad damage is the stuff that doesn't get reported, because they know that they've either been careless or negligent in some way, and that's the stuff that doesn't get reported, and of course that's the most dangerous. So it's not always a driver issue. It can be something to do with layout and equipment and that kind of thing. And a classic one was that we spotted in a test was that one particular leg was looking at, and I was reviewing the data with the customer, and I said, this has got a big spike on it, this leg, what's happening here? And they'd been checking it and they're finding no damage, but when we looked, what was happening is that somebody had placed some recycle bins close to towards the end of a rack, and placed some recycle bins there, which were restricting the movement of the forklift truck and sort of spoiling difficult access, and that was causing the problem. So they moved the recycle bins, put some protection against the rack end, put a barrier in there, problem solved. We're identifying where there's a problem before it occurs, and we're predicting, if you don't do something here, there's a good chance that you'll have damage. And of course, if you have damage, that's expensive anyway, but it could lead to a serious incident.
I like to say why RackEye, and just a couple of key points which I think offer the biggest benefit for the system.
It's a peace of mind for the customer. You don't have a traceability of paperwork. So everything is documented on your app, everything's documented on your dashboard, so you can always find a history of all your racking inspections that you've done over the years. If a racking inspector does come in, you can show him exactly what's been hit.
It's a 24/7 racking monitoring system. It offers alerts no matter what the time, it never stops. And I always like to describe it as if there is somebody staring at your racking and he's gonna come and run and tell you as soon as it's been impacted.
And it's talking to customers and understanding what that means to them, and asking those questions and saying, all I do is look at the data and go, that's what I see. Well, you get a lot of impacts on a Wednesday, and that, you know, that might be a classic thing, is a particular day in the week, and the usual example that I get on that is, well, that's our busy day, and that's when there's a lot of activity, that's our busy day. And I say, okay, so if that's your busy day, then surely that's your most high risk day. What we say to customers is, what you want to be looking at is, look at your warnings and graph it over time, and that's one of the classic graphs that we put for them. And if that graph's going up, if you get more and more warnings, then that's the wrong direction. What you want to see is that going down and leveling out. Where that's been most successful for certain is where the customer has engaged with their whole team for it. So what it does is it actually improves the reporting that's required under the current system and the current standard. So not only does it give you that extra level of protection, it actually reinforces and improves what's required there by the standard anyway. Some customers don't even realise how much they should be checking things either until you sort of talk to them. And often some companies that are growing quite rapidly, sort of medium-sized companies, they might have resource issues in terms of doing their inspection. And often, unfortunately, one of the things that really gets them focused on it is if they've had some kind of damage or an incident that's happened. And it might not be at their site, it might be another site in the group. They go, okay, we need to look at this more seriously. And it has different interests for different people in the organisation. So the guy that does the inspections, we were presenting to one guy, and he said, oh, I'd have this system just for the app, the inspection app. Because it's an easy way to do his inspections. They're all documented in the same place. They're automatically documented. He can take photographs of any incidents, of any damage, before and after photographs. And again, that's additional information that's not there at the moment. Most systems are manual, and the standard requires that they should document all inspections anyway. You can do an inspection through the app even if there hasn't been an incident. So again, the standard requires there should be an annual inspection by a competent person, and that could be carried out through the app. So everything's in one place as required. Up until this point, we had a kind of a soft launch, if you like. We've then got some key customers that, particularly ones that worked on development or have been interested right from the early days of it. Now that we've actually got some live customers and we've got all the necessary approvals as well, approved for anywhere from Europe, obviously UK and US, I believe now. And we'll get approval in other regions, and that'll be very much customer driven.
We already had a first generation of product, and we had feedback from customers. So we started off with a pretty clear understanding of what we thought the customers' needs were. So we had numerous brainstorming sessions looking at different ways we could address this problem, different ways we could architect the system, store the data, analyze the data. And the key for us was to make a system that was, you know, incredibly reliable, because you know, it becomes part of critical safety infrastructure. We had to make sure it was globally accessible. We had to ensure that we had complete confidence that if an event happened, we were always going to receive that data. And we therefore built a quite advanced system.
We've got different things going along in the development all the time. They're updating software on a regular basis. They've got also a longer term future in terms of where RackEye, what the next generation of RackEye will look like, and new features that will be in there, and other products that will go alongside it. So it's the first true technology product, I think, that ACS actually launched, and it'll be the first of many.
See, when we first launched the product, we were doing, you know, relatively small installations. Customers who were evaluating the technology. But as we've grown and the size of the installations have grown, we are finding, you know, that the system, although it's incredibly robust and reliable, we've found new ways that we can do things. We have found new ways of making the app work, for instance, that you know makes it quicker to respond. We've improved the software on the gateway.
The way the app has been built in for RackEye is to support the EN15635 process. So we assess it against the EN15635 standard, which is the same standard that people like SEMA use to train inspectors. And that's what's defined around Europe and what most of the bigger companies will use generally around the world as the sort of gold standard as to how you're, what shows if your racking is safe or not. And within that standard, it tells you things like significant numbers of multiple impacts can cause damage. Damage may not occur immediately. It can take several hours or even days for a collapse to occur.